That half a second is able to get that shot off.
All right, let's hear from Christian Fischer after two periods of play. He's with Trevor downstairs, T.
A couple of points and a three-goal second period for the Red Wings here tonight by Christian Fischer. And first of all, Fischer, on that breakaway and the puck's rolling like that, how do you settle it down and what's the game plan in your mind at that point?
Not too much going on in my brain there. Just obviously when it's on its side like that, you just have to get a shot on, really. Obviously, good pass there by Mike, and fortunate for it to go 5-hole. It's good.
They got one back that certainly gave their bench a little bit of momentum, and then you answered with two more. How important was Larkin's goal to make this a two-goal game at that point, and how do you feel about him scoring in his first game back?
I mean, I could go on and on for how much that guy does for this team and how much he means to us. You hear the crowd, they know Larkin's back, and so do we. You know, big plays like that, that's our captain. We love him. And then obviously, like you just said, two-goal lead, that's huge. That's a really good team. We knew we had to stay patient. Obviously, a three-goal period, four goals, that's probably not too often that happens against them. But we're in a great spot, 20 minutes, to have a two-goal lead and win this game.
Good luck locking it down in third. Thanks for this.
Sorry, Mom, about swearing. My bad.
Thanks. But there goes Christian Fischer. He and the Red Wings with 20 more minutes to lock this thing down, John.
And we add our apology as well. You can feel the emotion in the building. The Wings lead by two after two. Wings and Islanders split the first two meetings. It's Detroit with a 3-1 lead in the third, trying to hang on to that second wild card spot in the Eastern Conference. This intermission report is presented to you on Valley Sports Detroit by MGM Grand Detroit.